ready. Ready when you are.
Call of Duty.
Call of Duty.
Call of Duty was taking over the world.
Call of Duty is the biggest franchise in entertainment history.
Paris, Australia.
London. A global phenomenon.
I'm still trying to get the hang of it.
Awesome. Let's head to the Call of Duty green room.
Call of Duty Endowment helped find me.
I'm what they call a newbie. I could be killed in about 4 seconds.
Run a jet to a gunfight.
The controller's not working.
In all seriousness, I love the ways that you find a duck.
So, Jesus, what have you been doing since you've been back?
Just kind of bumming around, playing a little Call of Duty.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Activision CEO, Eric Hirschberg.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's great to be here. To everyone in attendance here in Los Angeles, to everyone joining us all around the world, on behalf of everyone here at Activision, including our incredibly talented team at Infinity Ward, to our friends at Xbox who helped us put on this event today, and our partners everywhere, welcome. It's a privilege to get up here and represent one of the biggest entertainment franchises in the world. There is an unofficial but widely observed holiday that happens all over the world every November, and it's called Call of Duty time. We are blessed with the best fans in the world. From the millions who stand online in countries all over the globe, to the countless people that share their creativity and excitement and feedback with us every single day, who are a huge part of our creative process. When it comes to passion and engagement, I'd put Call of Duty's fans up against any fan base of any other form of entertainment in the world. You are the reason we do what we do, and today is all for you. Now, obviously, this is a big year for games, with the next generation of hardware just about to launch. And it's awesome as the current generation of hardware has been, the pop cultural landscape has changed immensely all around it since it started. Think about it. Things like YouTube and Facebook and smartphones and tablets, things we couldn't imagine life without today, most of them didn't even exist when the current generation of hardware was announced. James Bond was played by a guy named Pierce Brosnan. Iron Man was just a comic book. And here in LA, the Avengers were better known as our local arena football team than as a movie franchise. So a lot's changed since the current generation started. Lots of entertainment franchises, technology, social movements, institutions have come and gone. But one remains stronger and more relevant than ever, Call of Duty. In that time, in fact, more than 100 million of us have played this game. More than 40 million of us have played it this month. And more than 10 million of us will play it today. The fact is, more people are playing this game than ever before. So how did we get here? How did Call of Duty become such a phenomenon? I've been asked to decode the secret sauce of Call of Duty countless times. Is it the archetypal fantasy of being a hero, unlocking that inner soldier in all of us? Is it the technology? Is it the graphics? The silky smooth controls, the stories, the frame rate, the progression system. Sure, it's all those things. All those things matter, and I would argue that our developers have delivered them more consistently and better than anyone else in the world. But at the end of the day, none of that matters if they don't all combine to add up to that one essential ingredient that's at the heart of every Call of Duty game, and that's fun. incredible gameplay experiences. You can't count on much in this world, but you can count every year on Call of Duty to make your knuckles white, your heart race, to unleash your competitive fire and trigger your holy shit reflex more consistently than any other form of entertainment in the world. Adrenalized, competitive, over the top, thrill ride with your hair on fire, fun. That's what got us here. I'm assuming that's why you're here. So let's not waste any more time. Let's get to it and check out the world premiere of the next generation of Call of Duty multiplayer in Call of Duty Ghosts. By the way, if you were wondering which Eminem song you were just hearing in our trailer, there's a reason you weren't able to figure it out, and that's because the first time the world has ever heard it was just now. The song's called Survival, and it's the first song the world has heard from Eminem's upcoming album, which drops this fall. He's been a great collaborator with this franchise over the years. His music's been in our games, his music's been in multiple trailers, and it's pretty cool that he chose our stage to share the first song with the world from his upcoming album. And in fact, he wanted to say a few words to our fans. Listen.
What's up, Call of Duty fans? I'm sure you're getting excited about Ghosts. I am too. Just gave you a sneak peek for the first time anywhere on my new song called Survival. The song's about fighting back, and it seems like it fits Ghost perfectly. I'm gonna be a big part of the game. My new song's in it. Got a video dropping soon for it too. Stay tuned, we've got some more surprises in store for you.
That's how I'm gonna walk off later, if that's okay with you. Okay, so let's dig a little deeper into Call of Duty Ghosts multiplayer. This MP game is built on three main pillars. Number one, your soldier. Character customization in Ghosts gives you over 20,000 possible combinations that allow you to personalize how you look and how you play the game like never before. And all this customization, as cool as it is, it's not just cosmetic. It's not just about expressiveness. It leads to all new gameplay experiences as well, like our new squads mode that you're gonna hear a lot more about later in the show. Number two, your world. In Call of Duty Ghosts, as you can see in the trailer, the world in multiplayer literally shifts beneath your feet with our first ever dynamic map events, which makes the game more strategic, more challenging, and more fun than ever before. It also gives new meaning to the phrase, I gotta learn the maps. Up until now, that's meant you've gotta learn how the maps were laid out. Now you have to learn what they can do and what you can do to them to change the game, change the world, and get the upper hand. But that's not the only way that the multiplayer world has changed. Ghosts and IW are introducing 7 new game modes, more than 30 new weapons, including an entirely new weapon class, more than 20 new kill streaks, new ways for your character to move through the world with new animation systems, an all new co-op mode, and it's all fueled by our new next gen engine that, as you can see, makes this the best looking Call of Duty multiplayer game ever. And three is the ability to take Call of Duty with you anywhere. Fueled by your Call of Duty account, which 20 million of our players already have when they signed up for Call of Duty Elite, you can now carry your profile, your accomplishments, your prestige level, everything you've invested in the game from the current gen to the next gen and from console to console within the console family. So you go over to your friend's house, you log in there, all the progress you've made goes with you. Let's say you decide to upgrade from an Xbox 360 to an Xbox One. Your stats, your profile, your unlocks, your progression, your prestige level, all the time you've invested in this game, it all goes with you into the next gen. Your Call of Duty account also unlocks a new mobile app. The app takes some of the best and most popular pieces of Call of Duty Elite and also adds new breakthrough innovations and features designed to work from the ground up, hand in hand, tightly with Call of Duty Ghosts, including deeper clans experience, a new and unique mobile metagame that gives you a whole new way to compete with your friends and level up called Clan Wars. And rest assured, this is the all-inclusive Call of Duty experience you've come to expect from us. Single player, multiplayer, co-op, second screen, and it all runs at 60 frames per second on all platforms, both current gen and next gen. And there's nobody better suited to lead Call of Duty into the next generation than our iconic studio, Infinity Ward. This is the studio that not only created Call of Duty, but also set the gold standard for this genre, for this generation, with the Modern Warfare series, and that's exactly what they're gonna do again with Ghosts. So to tell you more about it, it's my pleasure to introduce the executive producer, my good friend from Infinity Ward, Mark Rubin.
All right, thank you. Hey, everybody. First off, I just want to say on behalf of everyone at Infinity Ward and the teams at Raven and Neversoft, thank you for joining us. I have to say also that over the years, watching our guys create multiplayer has been a fascinating experience. It's one of the most organic yet thorough processes I've ever been a part of. From a design focus for us, it's always about the gameplay. So everything is designed to enhance the experience and ensure that can be as absolutely as fun as possible. If a new idea doesn't make it better, then no matter how cool it sounds, it's cut. For Call of Duty Ghosts multiplayer, everything got touched. Nothing was sacred. We went through every single system in the game, from maps and modes, to animation and audio, to who you are as a player. This is the biggest overhaul of multiplayer we've done since the original Modern Warfare. So let's get started. When we brought Create a Class and the perk system to our players for the first time in the original Modern Warfare, we had hoped it would be received well. And it's great to see how the community has embraced it. This year, we believe our new system is the most flexible and comprehensive character customization yet. So in Ghosts, you don't just create a class, you create a soldier. You know, in the past, we allowed you to customize your loadouts, but you're really just a randomly generated character. So for Ghosts, we wanted to empower the player to customize who they are. So the first thing you do when you create your soldier is you're gonna pick what you look like. You're gonna choose the head, the body type, the headgear. And like Eric mentioned, there are over 20,000 possible combinations. And as you saw from the trailer, you can also play as a female soldier. Now let's talk about weapons. We're bringing a massive amount of new weapons to Call of Duty Ghosts. Overall, there's more than 30 new weapons across assault rifles, shotguns, launchers, LMGs, and more. It's an 80% overhaul from Modern Warfare 3. We've also created a new weapon class, a whole new weapon class that bridges the gap between sniper class and assault class. It's called marksman rifles. These weapons can be used as scoped semi-automatic sniper rifles or as iron sight-based single-shot assault rifles. For me personally, these remind me of my days of Call of Duty 1 and Call of Duty 2, playing with weapons like the M1 in the car. They take a lot of skill to use, but it was really rewarding to get a kill. And one of the things that shows off our advance in weapons the most is we've added scopes with dual render technology, which allow you to target, keep your target in sight and still maintain your peripheral vision. So overall, we've completely redone the way the weapons look, the way they feel, and the way they sound. And we can't wait for you guys to get your hands on them. So customization for us means more than just the look of your soldier. It also means giving you greater control in customizing your loadout. So we really liked what Treyarch did with the Pick 10 system in Black Ops 2. And we've incorporated a similar approach to our Create a Soldier system. In Ghosts, you're allocated a budget for your primary weapon, secondary weapon, your lethal and tactical equipment, and your perks. All attachments and killstreaks are free. So let's get into the way perks work. First, we're bringing more perks than we've ever had before, and very importantly, a whole new way to select them. So every perk has a set point value from 1 to 5, and you have 8 points to use how you want. So for example, I could choose 4 perks, each valued at 2 points apiece, or 8 perks, each valued at 1. I could also choose to get rid of my secondary weapon and my equipment and get up to 11 perks. This provides a whole new level of strategy and customization to our Create a Soldier system. You have the freedom to pick what you want and play how you want. And that includes killstreaks. So for killstreaks, we've added over 20 new ones to Ghosts, such as Juggernaut Maniac, Helo Scout, Vulture, and Odin Strike. And of course, one of my favorites is you get to call in Riley as a guard dog. He'll follow you around the map, taking out enemies that get close, and he'll actually even act like a UAV by growling when enemies are near. We really had a lot of fun actually designing these killstreaks. And like Modern Warfare 3, you earn these killstreaks not just through kills, but also by completing game mode objectives. Now we're also bringing back strike packages, assault, support, and specialist. And we got a lot of great feedback from the community and have put a ton of work in making these killstreak packages more unique and well-defined. So one of the things we're doing is we're reducing the number of air-based killstreaks and replacing them with more visceral, in-your-face, ground-based ones. For instance, UAV is now a ground-based device called SATCOM instead of a drone in the air. So players won't need special equipment to take it out, but it also adds a new layer of strategy for the player calling it in as they can try and hide it from enemies. When it comes to the support package, not only did we reduce the overall lethality of it, but it's been designed to better reward your contribution to your team. So we focused on kill streaks that counter enemy equipment, provide increased map awareness, and support your team in a variety of deployables. And as a side note, there are no more death streaks. So we've just talked about all the things available to you in Create a Soldier. Now let's talk about how you earn those things. So as you earn XP in Call of Duty Ghosts, you'll receive squad points that you can use to unlock weapons, killstreaks, attachments, and equipment. The key difference is that you choose which weapons, killstreaks, etc., you get to unlock in the order you want. So if I want the first weapon I unlock to be the new IA-2 marksman rifle, As soon as I have enough squad points, I can unlock it right away. So what I've just described is how you customize a single soldier. But in Ghosts, we're actually allowing you to create a squad of up to 10 soldiers, each one with its own unlocks, loadouts, appearance, and prestige. So as you play each of these soldiers, you earn XP. And once you've earned enough, that soldier prestiges. But this time, you get to keep everything you've unlocked. So 10 soldiers, one level of prestige per soldier, equals 10 levels of prestige. There's more to squads than just progression, but I'll come back to that in a second. So let's now start talking about some of the new modes for Call of Duty Ghosts, a couple of which we're gonna see today. First, let's talk about Cranked. This is similar to Team Deathmatch, but with an even faster pace. When you get a kill, you gain faster movement, reload, and ADS. But there's a catch. You also gain a countdown clock. So you have to rack up your next kill before the timer hits zero, or you'll explode. Why not? And so you're not really just competing against kills, you're also competing against the clock. Next up is Search and Rescue. So this is a take on Search and Destroy, but instead of being done for the round when you're killed, in Search and Rescue, your team can revive you and get you back into the action. The way this works is when a player dies, they drop a tag. If an ally picks up that tag, then that player respawns. If an enemy picks up the tag, then the player is out for the round. So it's important for players to not only grab their allies' tags, but also grab their enemies' tags. And this really adds an extra layer of excitement for both teams, as you're not only competing for the objectives, but you're also competing for your teammates' tags. So I mentioned earlier this idea of creating a squad of up to 10 soldiers. And what that's done is it's led us to creating a whole new third game mode. It's called Squads. This is something you can do solo, cooperatively, or competitively. It's based around the idea of taking your squad that you've created in multiplayer and competing against AI or other players. And your progress here counts towards multiplayer. So you'll be earning XP and ranking up by playing squads. This new mode is for players of all skill levels and shows off the tremendous amount of work we've done on the AI. They act more like human players than anything we've ever created. And I mean this for real. They'll drop shot, they'll side strafe, they'll corner camp, and they'll jump shot. It's amazing how much they play like real players. And you, like myself, may find yourself yelling at them as if they were. Also important is your loadout choices actually directly change the impact of how your squad will behave. So if you equip one of your squad mates with a sniper rifle, he'll act like a sniper. Same goes for SMG, LMG, Assault. This is a really big new gameplay option. So let's take a deeper look.
Our new squad mode introduces a whole new level of competition to Call of Duty. We've taken the best parts of the multiplayer experience and combined that with a vastly improved AI and our new mechanic of creating your own squad mates. All the hard work you've put into customizing, playing, and prestiging your squad can now be put to use on a brand new playing field. Squads is for all skill levels and offers a variety of gameplay modes to choose from, both solo and cooperative. Your progress here counts towards multiplayer, so you'll be earning XP and ranking up by playing squads. Let's look at some of the modes. In our new squad versus squad mode, you'll be able to compete against other players one-on-one with your squads as teammates. It'll take more than just your personal skill in this mode. A winning strategy will come from finding the right combination of loadouts for each soldier in your squad. In War Game, you will handpick five of your squadmates to battle it out against an advanced AI-controlled team that replicates the full multiplayer experience. War Game can be played in every game mode available in multiplayer.
Kill confirmed.
We've added an all-new four-player co-op mode called Safeguard. This was inspired by survival in Modern Warfare 3. In this wave-based mode, you get to use all of the toys of multiplayer, including killstreaks, perks, and weapons. Finally, in Squad Assault, you and your friends play in an epic six-player co-op match against an offline player squad. You'll be able to matchmake against squads made by players around the world or choose one of your friends' squads to assault. You'll be able to challenge these offline squads with 5 other players or go in solo with 5 of your squad members. This mode adds a sense of strategy for the offline player as well, as not only will they choose the loadouts of their offline squad, but they also get to choose the map and mode that their squad will defend. And they will be earning XP if their squad does well. With squads, we've taken some of our innovative new game mechanics and created a whole new gameplay experience for players to enjoy.
All right, so we've talked about who you are as a player, and we've talked about how you could create a squad of soldiers to use in both multiplayer and squads. But equally important is the world in which you're playing. Over the years, we've challenged ourselves to set the bar in multiplayer map design to deliver fast, frantic, quick-hitting, Call of Duty-style gameplay. With Ghosts, we've pushed ourselves even further, making sure to innovate in new ways that deliver a unique experience in every map. We're immersing players in the multiplayer maps in ways similar to what we've done cinematically in single player, while adding new ways to play and interact with the environments in a meaningful way. So we've introduced new interactive elements and player-triggered events that make the maps evolve as the match goes on. There's a huge range here, from player-triggered traps to map-changing killstreaks. The entire landscape can shift and require new tactics and strategies. Take the map Octane, for example, where you can blow up a gas station to take out enemies and create new cover, or you can set explosives on a wall to open up a new line of sight. Also, on certain modes, there's a care package that we've hidden on the map. And it's all about player control. When these are used, they have a direct impact on the match. So our map design, it wouldn't be possible without the new tech that we're bringing to Ghosts. Not only does the tech allow us to create these new dynamic events, but also adds a new level of immersion to our maps. From graphics to animation to audio, we set our sights on making this the most visceral experience we've ever created. For next gen, things like sub-D, displacement mapping, and real-time lighting give us the tools to create this new world. One of the key successes for Call of Duty is how it feels, the controls, moving through the world. The attention to detail is what makes Call of Duty feel right. But we knew we could make it even better. So we've redefined how you, the player, move through the world. Everything will feel better, from the weapons you use to how you traverse the environment. And we've given players new ways to engage in combat. So some examples, we've added a contextual lean system that allows you to naturally lean around obstacles without adding button combinations. It's intuitive and seamless. We've also added a new mantling system. This allows you to move fluidly over objects while not losing momentum, whether low mantling while firing your weapon or jump mantling from rooftop to rooftop. And one of my new favorites is the knee slide. This is a way to naturally transition from sprinting to crouch or prone. This allows you to maintain momentum as you move through the world. All of these new movements are designed to enhance the experience and controls you already know. So as I mentioned earlier, audio was a key focus in developing our new engine. In particular, creating an audio design that complemented all of our new graphical enhancements. So some of the new features we've added are an ADSR-based reverb system, reactive emitters, and locational battle chatter. So let's take a look.
The next-gen audio engine in Call of Duty Ghosts will help the player really feel enveloped and connected to their environment. We have greatly improved our player connection to the world through audio. One of the ways that we did that is through the new reverb engine. It's a much more realistic algorithm that works for interiors. It changes real time as you walk into a different area. The
So a giant metal large space would sound completely different from a small carpeted room. There is definitely an advantage having the reverb and multiplier. You will be able to know when people are inside your space.
One new multiplayer feature that we've upgraded in Call of Duty Ghosts is what we call locational battle chatter.
Contact shooters in that restaurant!
Not only will your teammates tell you when a grenade goes out or when they kill an enemy,
target neutralized.
Now they'll tell you when they've actually spotted an enemy near a landmark.
Hostiles taking positions near the totem pole! Tango's in the courtyard!
We're really excited about this feature and how it's going to bring people together online and work as a team.
They're coming through the back entrance!
Other additions to the next-gen engine for audio is something that we call reactive emitters.
Little nodes that we place on actual objects in the game that react to an explosion. When you throw a grenade and it explodes over there, I might hear something behind me that is actually reacting to the shockwave. The next-gen platforms will really offer us a lot more flexibility and just pure quality. It will really, really enhance the overall Call of Duty experience.
Enemies over by the junkyard! I got movement in the intersection! Target sighted on that bridge!
So it's important for all of our fans to know that the current gen versions are benefiting from all the new tech we're putting into Call of Duty Ghosts. And this includes all of the gameplay features that were discussed today. This will be the best looking current gen version of Call of Duty we've ever made. All right, so let's touch on esports. Call of Duty took competitive gaming to a new level last year with Treyarch and Black Ops 2. The Call of Duty Championship held back in April was a huge success and a lot of fun to watch. With Call of Duty Ghosts, we're continuing to support competitive gaming. The Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox returns in 2014. Additionally, Call of Duty Ghosts will be the exclusive first-person action game and flagship title on the MLG Pro Circuit in 2014. So stay tuned for more esports info in the weeks to come. But enough talk. Let's see some live gameplay. Please welcome to the stage two of the best Call of Duty shoutcasters in the world and the guys that announced the Call of Duty World Championship, Fwizz and Benson.
That's right, we're used to casting matches featuring some of the best Call of Duty players in the world, but to be honest, to have the privilege to cast the first ever live Call of Duty Ghost match is something special. But obviously in order to do that, we're gonna need some players. So for this exhibition match, we wanted to go out, we got the toughest guys in the world, and then we teamed them together with some of the best players in the world. And the pros that are about to take the stage certainly aren't the toughest guys in the world, that's not who I'm talking about, but it's our US Marines. So let's go ahead and bring out our teams. On our Federation squad, from left to right, Call of Duty pro player Nate Shot from Optic Gaming. You've got Clayster from Complexity Gaming and Liar from Curse Gaming. Joining them from the US Marines are gonna be Private First Class Malaysio from Rockford, Illinois, Corporal Plow from Shawnee, Oklahoma, and Lance Corporal Kelly from Oakland, California.
That's right, Fwizz. I've got over here Team Ghosts from left to right, Call of Duty pro players, Big Timer from Optic Gaming. We've got JCap from Team Envious, and of course, TP from Complexity Gaming. And joining them from the US Marines, we've got Lance Corporal Rodriguez from Denver, Colorado, Sergeant Garces from San Angelo, Texas, and from the US Navy, HM1 Sanyel from San Diego, California.
All right, so yeah, I gotta give up for him. So now that we got the teams all locked up, let's talk about the new game mode we're gonna be playing. It's gonna be Cranked. As Mark mentioned earlier, this is a new take on everyone's favorite game mode, Team Deathmatch. But here's the twist. Every time you get a kill, you start a 30-second timer. If you fail to get a kill within those 30 seconds, you heard, you explode, and you die. It's that simple. So, for every kill that you get one of Call of Duty's favorite perks. So that's Last Stand, Martyrdom, and of course, Painkiller. No, I'm just kidding. Look, you guys are all like, what? No, I'm just kidding. None of that's in the game anymore. I've spent a lot of time playing with it. So for every time you actually get a kill, you get something that's going to make you quicker. So like sleight of hand, extreme conditioning, quick draw, stalker. So as the clock is ticking down, you just become faster and faster as the time's dwindling down on the clock. So I guess ultimately what I have to say here is if you're a camper, good luck. That's all I got to say to that. So Benson, we got the teams. We got the game mode all figured out. What map are we going to play on?
Well, you know, for me, it has to be Strike Zone. So Strike Zone is a really small, war-torn baseball stadium. It's small, it promotes fast-paced gameplay, and you're going to get into a ton of close-quarter combat. It's the perfect map for this mode of play. You know what, Fwiz? Let's go to the casting booth.
Let's get to the booth. All right, guys, get ready for this match. Chabot! All right, as we're going to kick it off, we're going to jump in the eyes of Big Timer. Big Timer is a member of Optic Gaming. He's also a 13-time champion. He's the most successful player in the history of Call of Duty. He's going to try to help his team, and they are off to a good start at 11-4. Big Timer looking to get his first kill, and now he's cranked. So time's running down on the clock. Picks up another one, finally gets taken out there. Let's switch on board with Nadeshot, who's actually on the other team, but an Optic Gaming member. So we're gonna get in the eyes of Nadeshot, see if he's able to get his team back on his shoulder. He's gonna pick up his first kill there. So Nadeshot, time dwindling down on the clock, 25 seconds left and cranked. He's gonna play a little bit conservative here to see if he can get a kill. Pops up, takes him out, and nice play by him.
Now, Fwiz, it's really important to mention in Call of Duty Ghosts, as soon as the first player dies, he's going to go ahead and drop a briefcase. Now, from that briefcase, you're going to get a field order. It could be absolutely anything from humiliate your opponent to get a headshot, get 2 kills whilst prone. If you get that, you're actually going to go ahead and get a care package. And from that care package, you get absolutely anything. Could even be an Odin Strike.
And TP has it right now. So if he's able to get the Odin Strike from this, from the field orders, that's
minimal chance.
It just decimates everything. You guys are going to love it. I hope he's able to pull it off here. So TP, 18 seconds left. The field order is down. He was not able to complete it. So now you got to wonder who's able to pick it up. Let's jump on board with Lance Corporal Rodriguez here. He is cranked with 25 seconds left. He's going to try to do something about it. Frantically looking for his team, and now he's got somebody in his sights, gets taken out there, and the field order's yet to be picked up and executed on Benson.
Yep, that's gonna be somewhere down. Meanwhile, someone's actually on a 5-kill streak, but we'll stay on board with him for now as he's actually gonna get attacked from the right. Well, those seeds are played directly in front of him. There's actually a Night Owl flying around there. Yeah. That's nice to see. Someone get some streaks.
Absolutely, and now Clayster of Complexity, he's got the bomb, or the field order, and not able to do it. He did have the field orders for a quick second there, not able to capitalize on that. Close game between these two squads. 57 and 48 as we're going to switch in the eyes of Complexity's teammate there, TP. He is also on the squad that has got 3 consecutive championships now on their belt. They're doing a great job. He's going to try to bring that energy and intensity here for his team, 68 to 53. And now let's see what TP is able to do. He does. Oh, that was his teammate. There's the kill, and he's going to pick it up. So now TP is cranked. Everyone desperately still looking for those field orders to try to capitalize on that situation. Shots being fired, picks up another kill. TP on a roll. Benson, he's looking good now.
He's looking so good. He's currently 9-5. He's playing fantastic with 22 seconds left. Field orders have been received. All he now needs to do is actually get a kill off. But he's going to go down. Field orders failed once again, Fwiz.
Oh, man. It's tough. You know, it sounds easy because sometimes, you know, it'll be something as simple as getting, you know, 1 or 2 kills while prone, but in a game like Cranked where everything is moving so quickly and you are the energy and intensity is so high, it can be sometimes difficult to execute on that. Let's switch over, and I want to get in the eyes of Corporal Kelly as now they do have the Odin Strike. It looks like that's what's down there. Is that right, Benson?
It's there. They just need to pick it up.
Oh, my gosh.
I can see on the map. You can see that little tag just to Corporal Kelly's left-hand side. That is the sign of the Odin Strike. I'm not sure exactly where it's landed on the map. Hopefully they haven't got it. I mean, the chance of getting a minimal, they've got it and thrown it outside the map. Well, I mean, I did that. It's a bit of a nightmare, really.
It happens to the best of us sometimes, but they've not been able to go get it. So we'll see what's able to happen as we're going to stick on the eyes of Corporal Kelly here. See if the U.S. Marines can bring this one home. It is 109-78, so incredibly close matchup here between these two squads. Let's see, though, if they can come back.
Yep, very, very close game for now. But staying on him now, he is cranked. 24 seconds for him to try and pick up a kill. Obviously, if he doesn't get that kill, he is going to explode, and time is dwindling down. Just 20 seconds left.
And now jumping on with Optic Gaming's Nade Shot. He gets taken out. Now he's going to spot back in. Let's see if he's able to pick it up. He is cranked there. 27 seconds left. And now he's moving quickly to see if he can find anybody. You see Riley's on the map as well. seeing if he can help out Nate Shine Company.
Oh,
and there it is. Let's see what he's able to do. 18 seconds left. Still looking for somebody to pick up. Time's going to be down. Frantic. He's not. Is he able to get this kill? No. Nate Shine not able to come through with it. He's going to get taken out. 141 to 94. And now we are going to jump over to Big Timer. He's going to have to try to bring his team back in it because they are down and it is looking dismal for this squad. They've got to turn it around right away if they want to do something about it. And Big Timer looking to see if he can pick anybody up. And that is going to be it. It's going to be the Ghost Squad that pulls that one out. Everyone give it up for your Ghost Squad as they were able to take home the match. Look, I hope everyone enjoyed the match. And that was the first ever live Call of Duty Ghost match.
Welcome, senior producer Yale Miller.
Well, that was awesome. Thanks again for the players, and of course, our toughest competitors, the Marines. So Mark shared with you what your soldier, your team, and your world means to Ghosts. I'm going to detail how you can now take Call of Duty anywhere. And it all starts with your Call of Duty account. 2 years ago, we connected the Call of Duty community with Call of Duty Elite. And since then, we've listened and we've learned. And with Call of Duty Ghosts, you will see the future of Elite. For the over 20 million of you that have already signed up for Elite, you already have a Call of Duty account. This provides access to a ton of great services. For those of you without a Call of Duty account, simply sign up for free in-game or on the web to enjoy all the benefits. One of those awesome benefits that Eric actually mentioned earlier is the ability to take your profile with you from the Xbox 360 to the Xbox One. So if you're playing at a friend's house on their console or planning on picking up a next-gen console, we've got you covered. Your XP, your soldiers, your unlocks, your prestige will all come with you. It is that simple. With your account, you can also get access to the Call of Duty app. This provides a mobile experience designed to work directly with Call of Duty Ghosts. The app brings back some of the most popular features of Elite, including tracking your career stats, like KDR, win ratio, hours played, as well as the ability to track your friends or your rival stats. And of course, the ability to push your loadout straight into the game. Created by Beachhead Studio in collaboration with Infinity Ward, the app will launch this fall with Ghosts. It adds a whole new dimension to the game by allowing fans to stay connected wherever they go, and also to engage in a bunch of new experiences. It has second screen support that's there to enhance your experience, but not to get in the way. Pre-match, you can edit your squad and have it available for your next game. And actually in-game, with one touch, you can actually pick your loadout for your next spawn. Plus, of course, if you kick ass in your last match, you can very, very easily share that with your friends via Facebook or Twitter. So one of the best things about multiplayer, the ability to play with your friends. And one of the biggest new features that we're integrating into the app and into the game is robust clan support. Now with your Call of Duty account, you can join a clan, create a clan, and manage a clan, all from in-game or from the app. When you're in a clan, communicating is key. With the app, you can easily keep in touch with them via the clan chat and rally up features. So clan chat lets you communicate directly with your clan members, while rally up allows you to choose the friends you want to play with and notify them via their mobile device or in game that you're ready to play a match and you want some friends to jump in with you. We've also built a new touch-based emblem editor straight into the app. This allows you to create the emblem that best fits your clan. The team also wanted to make sure that every clan member feels like they're bringing value and can help the clan level up. We've added more ways to contribute to your clan this year by rewarding clan XP for any multiplayer match that you play with your clan. Ghost also includes, for the first time, clan v clan playlists. So what does that mean? It means that you can very, very easily in-game jump into a match with your clan mates and directly challenge another clan. Finally, each time your clan levels up, there are more unlocks and rewards than ever before. These are built into the app as well as built into the game. And of course, all of these features that come with your Call of Duty account, including everything in the Call of Duty app, like second screen functionality and robust clan support, are available on both current and next generation. And your clan can actually now be comprised of people from Xbox 360 and Xbox Ones, making it easier for you to stay together and play with your friends. So there's one more thing for clans that we're really excited about, and that's called Clan Wars. It connects directly to the Ghost multiplayer game. And we're gonna show you a deeper look at Clan Wars right now.
We've worked a close partnership with Infinity Ward to really take clans to a new level. What we've done is we've built out a metagame, a game that lives within the mobile app and the mobile experience, but it's tied into the multiplayer matches. As a clan, you get paired up every 2 weeks against a series of other clans, clans that are of similar skill, similar size, similar location as you, and you have a battle over territories. You'll have one territory, maybe an oil rig, that's tied to team deathmatch. It'll have a series of wins you have to achieve as a clan. Each win, it will tally up, and if you're the first clan to occupy that space, you get points in Clan Wars, as well as XP bonuses in the game. The longer you hold that territory, the more points you get for your team. The team with the most points at the end of the 2 weeks wins the war. We've built the game so that one clan can't necessarily dominate the entire map. Once you've taken over a territory, it's your clan against all the other clans collectively. So it's gonna be very hard to maintain it. What's really cool is we really try to cater to all types of players. So whether you're a noob or you're an expert player, every win in multiplayer will contribute towards your clan. So as you build up wins for your team, you essentially will take over territories that give you unlocks and bonuses in the game. You'll get certain items in the game that you can only get from winning Clan Wars. Exclusive camos for your gun, helmets that are exclusive to Clan Wars. If you want to be the clan that dominates the game, you want to have all the items to show off how awesome your clan is. Clan Wars is going to be an ongoing battle. We actually plan on changing out new maps, keep it fresh, new locations, new bonuses, new game modes. We're very excited. It'll be an ongoing battle for the entire year. This kind of deep two-way interaction between the console and the second screen takes Call of Duty to a whole new level.
Please welcome back Eric Hirschberg.
So what do you think? Me too. I hope you can see that we're putting everything we've got into making Call of Duty Ghosts the most beautiful, the most customizable, the most polished and balanced and compelling multiplayer game yet. It's not easy to pull off games of this scale and this quality every single year for our fans, but that's exactly what our incredibly talented developers do every time. So let's give it up one more time for the team at Infinity Ward, as well as the teams at Raven and Neversoft. Best in the business. And it doesn't stop at launch. Our commitment to our players post-launch is second to none. If you've been playing the multiplayer game in Black Ops 2, I hope that you'd agree that we pour the same blood, sweat, and tears into making awesome, compelling, creative, and imaginative DLC as we do into the game itself. And speaking of DLC, for Ghosts, we're proud to announce that we're bringing back the Season Pass, which will deliver 4 mammoth new DLC packs for 1 great discounted price. Not only that, when you purchase the Season Pass, you'll get the Ghost Team Leader Pack. This is the first time we've offered an exclusive MP character, which is modeled after one of the key heroes from the Ghost single player campaign. And it comes with a bunch of other cool downloadable content as well. And when you're ready to upgrade to the next gen, we've got your back. If you order Season Pass, and then upgrade to the next gen within a console family, all of your DLC goes with you at no additional charge. The details will be posted. Also for Ghosts, we've cooked up what I think is our coolest collector's editions ever, loaded with everything a true Call of Duty fan could want. You can either get the all-new Hardened Edition or the ultra-limited Prestige Edition, which comes with the Call of Duty Ghosts tactical camera. It's a full HD, 1080p, water-resistant, wide-angle, wearable camera to record your own first-person action. This thing is on par with the leading cameras in the industry right now. It's legit, and it's been fully modeled after the helmet cams that the Ghosts wear in the game. But rather than hearing me describe it, we thought we would let two highly trained special ops soldiers take it into the field to capture in first-person the heroics that they live every day. Let's watch.
Hey guys, Call of Duty Ghosts is coming out with a special new collector's edition of the game that includes all sorts of ghosty stuff.
That's right, a paracord strap, a steelbook, and a season pass with all the map packs.
And these badass tactical HD cameras. So naturally, we're gonna do what you do when you have a badass tactical camera strapped to your head.
We're gonna breach some stuff.
Breach! Breach!
1, 2, 3!
Hi, guys.
All right, so we managed to make it shock-resistant and water-resistant, but not idiot-proof, obviously. The Collector's Edition and the Season Pass are available for pre-order starting right now at select retail outlets worldwide and online. So where do we go from here? Well, if you're here with us in the audience today, you're a few minutes away from being the first in the world to get hands-on with Call of Duty Ghosts multiplayer. If you're watching at home, we don't want you to be left out. We want you to get hands-on with the game as well. So today is merely the first stop in what we're calling the Call of Duty Ghosts Multiplayer World Tour. This is a 10-city tour of hands-on next-gen multiplayer events. It continues next week at Gamescom in Germany, and then heads through London, Dubai, Sydney, Sao Paulo, Paris, all over the world, straight through to our launch in November. So look for a tour stop near you and come play the game. Not only that, everyone in the audience here today will be getting a copy of the Prestige Edition free on us. And if you're watching at home, we don't want you to be left out. So look for a city near you on the Call of Duty World Tour. And if you can be one of the first 500 people in line to play Ghosts at any stop on our World Tour, you'll also be getting a copy of the Prestige Edition free on us. Before we go, I want to talk about giving back to the most important fans we have, some of whom are here today, the brave men and women who put themselves in harm's way and inspire each and every one of our games. I'm talking about our troops. So today I'm also really proud to reveal this year's awesome set of limited edition dog tags designed to benefit the Call of Duty endowment. Now, as you know, the endowment is near and dear to our heart. It's dedicated to finding quality jobs for our veterans when they return home. Activision has already given over $10 million to this cause so far. And you can get involved as well. To show your support, starting on November 5th, you can purchase these limited edition dog tags for a suggested retail price of just $4.99 when you pick up your copy of Ghosts at participating retailers. Buy them with pride. Wear them with pride and know that 100% of the profits will go to the endowment and its mission to help veterans find quality jobs. So thanks again to the best fans in the world and of course to our partners that help make Call of Duty the amazing franchise that it is, especially Xbox for helping us put on this event today. As I said at the beginning, it's almost Call of Duty time and the fun begins November 5th. So let's take one more look at the trailer, and then let's go play some multiplayer. Thank you.
When the thought of being thrown into an alligator pit, I salivated it. Waiting to
this. Stack your ammo, but don't come unless you come to battle. Now, now I'll jump in the sand. This is it. It's what you eat, sleep, piss, and shit. Live, breathe, your whole existence just consists of this. Refuse to quit. Refuse to sleep. Can't defuse the wick. I don't do this music shit. I lose my shit. Ain't got shit to lose. It's the moment of truth. It's all I know how to do. As soon as I get thrown in the pool, I spit. But my respect is over. Toolboxes, cause you never take my pride from me. It'll have to be pride from me, so pull out your pliers and your screwdriver.